In this video, I'm gonna talk about when is actually a good time to dip buy, when is it good to add to a dip buy, when is it good to cut your losses or even take small gains and exit when the dip buy isn't bouncing. Stay tuned, get ready to take some notes. What's up, Tim Sykes, Millionaire Mentor and Trader here. Answering your questions, I do a lot of dip buying. I don't like chasing stocks or anything for that matter. You know, when everything spikes too much in price, I back off. I oftentimes miss big run-ups because of that, but I like to stay safe, okay? I want you to understand that trading does not have to be as scary as many people think. A lot of people chase stuff, they go in too big, they use leverage, they go all in. These are all common newbie mistakes because you're greedy. You want to make a lot of money right away, you don't have the knowledge, you don't have the discipline, you don't have the experience to really be that aggressive. So everything that I teach is for beginner traders. You can always get more aggressive later on. A lot of my top students don't play by my rules anymore, but they already have millions as cushion in their bank accounts, and they have years of experience. They know how to play it safe. I would rather you learn how to play it safe first, then get more aggressive later on, or maybe not even ever get aggressive. You have to understand that, yes, I trade penny stocks. Yes, I day trade. Yes, sometimes, especially in the past, I short sell. These are all very dangerous techniques in the stock market if you let them. But understand, trading is not scary if you trade scared. Leave that comment below. That's what you have to understand. I know it's not a fun thing to say, oh, you wanna trade scared, like scared money doesn't make real money. Yes, it does. I've made millions and I trade scared. My top students have made millions and they traded scared. Again, you can make millions more being aggressive later on. Don't worry about being aggressive early on. If you actually look at how my students do, hardly anybody makes any serious money in their first year of trading. Why is that? Am I a scam? Is penny stocks trading a scam? Is the whole stock market a scam? No, no, no. It just takes time to learn the discipline. It takes time to learn what is your favorite strategy. Like I said, for me, it's dip buying. In this video, I want you to understand that when I'm dip buying, especially a morning panic, and you can click a link below, we have a blog post all about morning panics. When I am in a dip buy situation, or where I'm not necessarily even in the trade yet, but I'm looking for a potential dip buy, I want max panic as close to the market close as possible. That means stop losses going off, people freaking out, just max pandemonium, because that creates a pricing inefficiency where, you know, the stock might be too low. When the stock price is too low, it can bounce. What you have to understand is that when I'm looking for a dip buy, I want this max panic type situation. I want, you know, as many buyers to just get out, whether on purpose or because the price has gone too low, it's cracked some kind of support level. That creates a potential bounce because A, shorts want to cover usually for profits if it panics enough. Dip buyers like me come in because we see a deal. It's like a, you know, Black Friday deal. It's like a 50% off deal at, you know, Macy's. You can buy the same sweater that it was the day before for 50% off. With stocks, it's a little different. It's not the exact same company. If a stock is down 50%, there's probably some bad news. The market's tanking. There's some bad sector news. What you have to understand is that just because something is down 40, 50, 60% does not mean it has to bounce. That whole thing that I told you before I got started with the dip buys, when I'm talking about, you know, trading scared, that applies especially to dip buys. If you're in a play that's down a lot and you expected a quick bounce and it doesn't bounce that way, you got to start to think, what are you doing wrong? Did you get the situation wrong? Is the stock not going to bounce? Is it going to go even lower? You know, again, learn from my students, because a lot of other people don't have experience. So you don't have experience that you can, you know, learn from. Learn from the experience of my top students. Two of my top students, Jack Kellogg, Kyle Williams, their biggest loss, one loss, six figures each, was on MMNFF. It was a perfect supernova, perfect multi-day runner in the weed sector. Crashed 50, 60% in one morning. They thought it was gonna bounce. According to my charts, you know, it should have bounced. It didn't. It never bounced. And they kept adding as it went lower, eventually having to cut, and they each lost literally over $100,000 each. You don't need to do that, okay? Again, I was dip buying MMNFF that day too. I got out. I got out for a small profit or a small loss. I think it might have been a small profit. It doesn't even matter. That's not the point. Whether I had a small gain or a small loss, I'm thinking trading scared. I'm thinking, what if it doesn't bounce? I don't want to take too big of a position. I don't want to be stuck in this thing. And sure enough, it kept going down. It never bounced in the months since, years since. It has never bounced. Sometimes that happens. Dan Bilzerian's play. That was one of my best trades a little while ago when he mentioned BILZF was the ticker on his Instagram feed in his story. Sure enough, it gapped up. I locked in 40% profits because all of his people bought it the next day. It actually doubled within an hour of me selling, so I underestimated it. And then it crashed. Never bounced again. It crashed all the way from $4 down to the ones. Now I think it's like 35 cents. Never bounced. So when you go in and you think, oh, this stock is down too much. Oh, this crash, you know, is overdone. It can bounce. That's fine. Have that thesis. But if your thesis is busted, please remember this video lesson. Remember about staying safe. Remember about MMNFF. Remember about BILZF. It's not only five-letter tickers that are, you know, foreign companies. That's why they have those Fs at the end. They're foreign companies. It works for all stocks. Some stocks just aren't going to bounce. And again, I want you to get in the mindset of trading scared. Leave that comment below. Say, trading scared makes trading not so scary. And again, I know it's not fun. I know it's not exciting. But think about the fun and excitement you can have with more money in your bank accounts, okay? Trading is not about being fun. It's not always fun to be so disciplined. It's not fun to take losses quickly. It's not fun to be conservative. But it's crucial to your success in the long run. Again, if you want to ignore me, that's up to you, but I'm still going to throw this out there. And not to, you know, dampen the whole mood here, guess what? You don't always have to be so disciplined. You don't always have to be so conservative. Just like I always say, study hard, no days off. Some people are like, I don't want to study hard all my life. If it's no days off, you've like gone through life and you haven't even lived. I'm talking about in the beginning of your journey, okay? Do I study every day? Do I have no days off when I'm studying? No, because I don't study. I make video lessons for you. I am very well, tuned for these penny stocks. I don't need to study that much, if at all. I'm still watching, I'm still learning from my students more. Like I'm seeing what works for them and what works in any given market. But you have to understand that this is going to change over time based on your journey. In the beginning, you can be overly safe. In the beginning, trade with 100 shares, paper trade. You don't need to trade with big size. If you know that, you know, I have thousands of students, none of them are making big money in year one or year two. You're probably not going to make money in year one or year two, but you're honing your skills. Pascal is going to put up a picture of my first female millionaire student, this tweet, small is good. Tim Lee slash small is good. I remember it, where she was focusing on a morning panic dip by an OZSC. She trusted my process. She joined my challenge. I'll post a link to my challenge underneath if you want to be my next dedicated student. That's where all my 25 now millionaires are being created because they get all my DVDs, video lessons, a special chat room, mentoring, so much more. She made, I believe, $38 on an OZSC. Can you look at the tweet real quick? Timly, tim.ly/small is good. I made a little Tim Lee link for it so I can remember it. But I believe that she made $38 on a morning panic on OZSC. She practiced with a small position. She learned that skill. She loves morning panic dip buys. OZSC did used to bounce quite nicely. Promoted stocks often can bounce the most because the promoters want them to bounce so that they don't get investigated. That's a whole nother video. $38, I want to say, on our first trade. Can we confirm that? Still loading? Password is Hollywood. Capital H.
I know, I'm not getting it.
It's not going?
Yeah.
Anyways, she made $38 on her first trade. She really fine-tuned her dip buys. A few months later, she made $16,000 on the same ticker, the same pattern. You scale up in size, you get better over time with know-how and experience. So I know that trading is not fun when you're just learning and you're gonna be tempted to go bigger, you're gonna be tempted to hold longer. Don't give in to temptation. In the beginning, part of the reason why I'm saying like, wait, you're saying I'm not gonna make much money, if at all, year one or year two, why even do this? Because you're learning. Everybody wants to make millions right away, but they don't want to put in the time to learn. That's why I make videos like this. A lot of my job is just giving you the right tips and getting you the right perspective so that you stay in the game, you go through bull markets, you go through bear markets, you start learning so that by year 3, 4, 5, 10, is it $38?
I was telling you it was 9 minutes.
No, but is it $38? It is $38. By year 5, year 7, year 10, you have really honed your skills, whether it's, you know, shorting first red days, buying first green days, dip buying morning panics, buying morning spikes, shorting gapping craps. There's a few key strategies. And I know it might seem overwhelming right now. It's not going to be overwhelming for long if you study hard, if you follow these rules, and again, stay in the game. Leave a comment below. Say, I will trade scared to make trading not so scary. Thank me later.